With a new variant, the province is taking a new approach to managing COVID in BC schools.
This is going to look, though, very different from what has been in place before.
Before, it was known COVID cases in a school community that would mean health declaring an outbreak. But Omicron has outpaced the steps public health previously used.
Individual case management and contact tracing is no longer a helpful tool for us in tracking cases in schools.
So now the trigger for action will be how many kids are away. The number to set off that trigger will vary by school.
Schools will be monitoring attendance rates closely and will notify public health and the school community if attendance dips notably below typical rates for this time of year.
This notification about matters of concern will replace notifications school communities used to get for individual cases and potential exposures. Classes or schools going online will also depend on staff absences, and that will also differ by school. The new approach will also include an influx of rapid tests.
The key focus in the coming week will be, as I said, on supporting K-12 and return to school.
Details on just how or when they will be used isn't clear, but Dr. Henry is saying tests that are able to be done at home are being allocated to schools. When it comes to masks, she maintains that outside of a medical setting, the best one is a well-fitted one worn all day.
There are many things that we do in these structured settings to make sure that you don't have to rely on the moderately increased filtration capacity of a respirator versus a medical mask.
She says the mask is one of many prongs that protect from transmissions, along with daily health checks and keeping close contacts to the same people in school.
We know that we're not seeing explosive outbreaks of this virus in those settings where we have these things in place. That is a fact.
Also a fact that with community transmission so high in BC, the test positivity is at 25%, many in the school community will get sick. The education minister telling people to err on the side of caution when deciding if kids should go to school or not. But if sick, fully vaccinated people need to isolate for 5 days, those who are not, for 10.
This is going to be a challenging month, but it doesn't mean that we need to stop everything.
And as has been the case throughout the pandemic, the province pushing to ensure schools do not stop, not even in the face of Omicron. In Victoria, Lisa Yuzda, City News.